Okay, right now we're going to demo the boardroom meeting room, which is, they're all identical. All the meeting rooms, 1 through 6, and the boardroom are identical in operation. There's a home button on the touch panel, or which will bring you to the home page. And basically at the bottom it says touch screen to begin. So you touch that, and that brings up the only page for control. You basically have 3 level controls, whether it's the mic line input jack on the wall box, there's an air media jack, which is how you connect your computer to the display, and that controls the audio from your PC or laptop, or there's a mood media fader. And mood media is the music that's programmed to every room, basically, and you can raise or lower music. Right now, you basically have a level up and down and a mute. So if I raise, lower all these, and unmute, and if you want to just play music in the room, you go to the mood media, make sure it's unmuted, and you can basically raise it up just to play some background music in the room. Okay, and that's just if they want to have background music. The channel that's playing now may change based on what they want to have available for the meeting rooms. You can lower that to 0, or you can just hit mute. If you have a wireless mic system or a audio line fed into the wall jack, you would raise that up. There's nothing playing right now, which I'll demo over at the computer. And Air Media is the streaming box that your PC connects to, and this would raise or lower the level of audio coming from the PC. Home page, you can basically hit home here or hit the Wyndham logo. You've got, these are Ethernet network jacks for the room, okay? We're not going to be using those. The Air Media box, which is, this is the Air Media. This gets a network feed, but it's going to be behind the TV that's up here. So all of these will be hardwired in on the network out of the jack next to the coax jack. So behind the TV. Once these are installed, you won't have to do anything. Except We will have to talk about the audio when this is mounted up here.
Yeah, the audio will run through the wall, so you won't see the wire.
Right. Right now, there's a mic input. It's actually, it's on an XLR, okay, but it's actually a line input. So you will not be able to plug a microphone directly into this. You'll have to go through a mixer. Or if you have like a wireless lav system that has a line output, you just have to have like an unbalanced to XLR. That'll be your audio for a microphone system, okay? There's going to be another jack that's going to take audio out of the Air Media. Has this little mini 1/8-inch stereo that feeds audio out of this Air Media. Right now, we're utilizing this mic jack, mic line jack, to hear the audio from the Air Media, only for demonstration purposes. There will be another set of audio hooked up on a, one of these is going to convert to an audio cable for this box only that's going to be ran up in the wall. So once this will be mounted up here, you won't have to plug that in. That'll always be hooked up. Okay? So what we did was I took audio out of this box, plugged it in, and powered up the box. There's an HDMI output that I have fed to this test monitor. Normally that would go to a display. So like Rob said, envision this on the wall. And then I have a network jack fed from this dedicated jack here because this Air Media is on a different network than these are. So this is hooked up and ready to go. Once you hook these boxes up, you get this display. The Air Media goes on the network and comes up and shows you its IP address. So all someone has to do in a room, when they bring their laptop in, okay, they're on the network, there's a special wireless network called Air Media. The network administration people will give you this. There's two Wi-Fi networks that we use, AV Control for all the audio, and there's one just for the meeting rooms called Air Media. All the rooms are identical. So if you come into a room and someone has a laptop, they want to do a display, put their image on the display, you would turn the TV on, go to the input the Air Media box is hooked to, say it's HDMI 1. What you will see is that screen, and it has a IP address at the top. It says find address here. Someone would then go to their browser on their laptop, and they would basically put in that IP address. Okay? And just hit enter. And this is going to come up on their screen. If they have a Windows or a Mac, they click on the download button. When they do that, it's going to give them a file to save. Once they save that file, you go ahead and run it. Hit run. And these boxes have a code that would normally come up. You'd have to type a code in. I have the code disabled. The network people are going to have us give a dedicated code to each box and have it never change. So they'll be able to tell someone what the code is for each room. Right now I have that disabled. So automatically my display comes up on the display. So video is already transmitting. If you wanted to have audio, what we're going to do is I have this radio playing here, and it should be streaming right now. I'm just going to check levels. I'm going to use the iPad to come up, and at the bottom is a scrolling bar which scrolls through all the rooms that we have audio in the entire area. And down at the towards the end is meeting boardroom. There's all the meeting rooms. If I hit meeting boardroom, gives me the same layout that's on the touch panel. The line in plate is where I'm plugged into. So if I basically raise the volume up, the audio is, you have the display, now you have the audio to go with it. Again, we're using the line in plate to demo this audio. Normally, Air Media, you would be using the Air Media volume. And say they had a microphone in the room as well, you then could adjust the microphone level along with the PC level to get a mix of to balance it out. If you have no mic, you'd only have Air Media volume. Again, there's mute controls. You could mute the line in, say they go and have a break. You could have music playing. You just mute the music. You could then go back to the PC. And that's really all there is to it. There is some advanced features on the Air Media.
CBS is great.
Let me go ahead and bring this up. You could share this using remote view, but that's probably going to be a more advanced training that we might want to do, but you could share this. You could have multiple users as well. So you could have multiple laptops and everyone sharing their display. A general music area is the, when you enter the spa, there's speakers. There's speakers the whole way down the hallways until you get the whole way down to the hallway before you enter any of the treatment rooms. There's music, and there's also music in the nail salon and in all the locker rooms. That's all controlled in what's called Blue Harmony Spa lobby hall levels. Once you select that, you've got, it's basically 8 channels of Mood Media, which may get reduced to 6 channels. But it's back in our equipment room, there's 8 outputs from pre-programmed music that runs 24/7. It never stops. They can play any channel they want. I'm just going to pick 3 right now. So we're in the spa lobby. I'm just going to bring a fader up on Mood Media 3. Okay, so now that's going to be playing in all these speakers, the nail salon, the whole way down the hallways, which we're going to walk in the manager's office, which has a touch panel again, so you don't need the iPad to control anything anywhere, except for areas that don't have touch panels. So we can walk and see if we can get in the manager's office right now. We're in the manager's office. There's a touch panel on the wall that will control audio in the complete spa, in the lobby halls, and also in all the treatment rooms. The treatment rooms all have a BSS keypad also in the treatment room. So you can walk up to each treatment room and play a selection of Mood Media from 1 to 4. So right now, all these touch panels operate the same. If you hit the Wyndham logo, it takes you to the home page. Just says touch screen to begin. You select what room that you want to control. So I'll hit lobby hallways. And I had muted Mood Media 3. So if I unmute, that's now playing. If you want to have a different selection, you could turn that off and select a different Mood Media. But for now, I'm going to leave it on 3. So at this point, we can walk down the hallways and go to the treatment rooms. The spa lobby hall music plays throughout the entire spa in all the general areas except for the treatment rooms. The treatment rooms all have a BSS keypad where you can come into any treatment room and select Mood Media input 1, 2, 3, or 4. Control volume with the knob, or you press the knob and it will mute the audio. So now I can show you how to use one of the keypads. All right, all the keypads, very simple to operate. It has Mood Media 1, 2, 3, or 4. There's a button to the left of each one you want to select. All you do is press Mood Media 3 and use this knob to bring volume up. For that, you can change. Right now, we have it set for Mood Media 1 through 4. That may change depending on once they start to use the system. But basically, you can select each one, find one that you like. And if you press this knob in, it'll mute the audio. You can get the audio back by unmuting and just volume up and down. And that's basically, it's very simple to operate. All of these keypads are in all of the treatment rooms and they're all identical. Okay, we're in the ballroom. There's basically 5 separate rooms if the partitions are all closed, or one big room. We're in room number 5. Depending on how the partitions are, you can combine rooms together. Right now, they could have one big event. On the touch panel, you'd go to the room layout and you would combine everything, and that would combine everything into one big room, so whatever you selected to play would play through the speakers in the entire ballroom. If you have a single event in ballroom number 5, for example, which is where we're in, if you look at the partition, whatever you play would only, if this room is uncombined, it would only play in this room. And there's basically 2 selections depending on the wall plates. We also have video down here, as well as line level audio input jacks. So, for example, they're in a room, they want to play the microphone. It's a line output. They have it plugged into a jack. It lights up on the jack plate. You go to that, raise the volume, and her mic, they have those two rooms combined. Her mic is playing through all the speakers in that whole combined area. And that can all be done from any of these touch panels. There's one per room. There's five of them, because there's five rooms. Okay, the touchscreen, again, from the home page is the same thing. It says touchscreen to begin. It also shows you, this is ballroom five, that this defaults to, so you know that you're in ballroom five. You just touch the screen. On the left is a room layout. Once you get familiar with the room layout, like I said, where the projector screen is room one. Right next to it is two. Three is the whole entire middle area. Ballroom four is there, and we're in ballroom five. So right now, there's these buttons, and you have to use your, they're kind of small. You got your room layouts, one through five, but you have these combined buttons. So if you want to combine room one and two, you would hit combine. Now those two rooms are combined, which is how they had it playing. We're in room five. There's nothing combined with room five. You have three faders on the right. You got background music, which is labeled BGM, which is the mood media. You can select between mood media one through five on these bottom buttons. So if I select three and hit mood media, and I just want to raise that volume up, that'll play in this ballroom. If you don't want mood media, you can mute that. The middle button's called source. Source is what's plugged into, there's two jack plates per room. Depending on the location that they want to place something, they could have a wireless mic plugged into two different jacks in the room. There's an auto mixer built into the room combining, so you don't have to select those mics, they're automatically selected. So you plug it in and you come to your source, you would unmute and you would raise up, then you would hear your mic and you can adjust the volume. The far right fader is a master, and that's the master for this room that you're in. So you normally, you can keep the master up about 3/4, 7/8 of the way and really use your BGM or your source volume controls, which are actually faders, to adjust volume using mute and unmute. If you've got a mix going with the mic and music and they want silence in the room, you don't have the volume down. You can just hit mute so you can quickly go back and have your level back. The other thing in this room's unique because it has video distribution as well. On the jack plates, there's plates labeled source in and display out. Certain plates have a source in, but they don't have a display out. So you could plug a source in, which we've plugged the DVD player into a source in. In this same room, we went over to the other jack plate, and we plugged the display into the display out. So if you want to feed video, you would select video source. Right now, it shows you active input plates will have a green frame around them. Press active button to route video to that room. So as soon as you plug a source in, it gets detected. It will light up this button depending which plate it's plugged into. So you basically, and if you hook your display up to the display out in this room, you basically would press that and you would then see the video that you have plugged in. We have a DVD player plugged in. We have a display plugged in over there on display out. So that DVD is now routed up through the video switch and back down to that output. This room is going to get modified. They want to expand the capabilities. So it's basically going to be one big matrix mixer. So they could feed any display in to any output in the whole room. There may be events where they have the whole room. They say they have video inputs down there, but with the projectors, they could have multiple projectors. Say they have two video screens down here. So you'll be able to come and select two inputs and route that video to two different outputs or to one output. So those are new things that are gonna have to be programmed. So this was real basic, basically laying out a video source for each ballroom, two different plates to route video to the display out only within that ballroom. So that's going to change, where you'll be able to route anything to any output. So right now, that is basically the video, and it's hooked up now and working. The other capability, if we go back to room combine, if you wanted to play music throughout the whole ballroom, you basically would, you could combine, hit all these combines, and whatever you have routed now here is, I'll raise it up. It will play in the whole ballroom. And to quickly come out of that mode, you just uncombine. Like I say, you gotta have, it's kind of small. So now you're uncombined, you're back in ballroom 5, so you're only gonna control this ballroom. And that's the basic operation. You can do it, it's a little easier to do it on the iPad because it's a bigger screen, but it's the identical layout of this touch panel, just on an iPad. So basically that's the ballroom operation. Okay, just gonna give you a general layout operation using an iPad or the touch panel that is mounted up in the AV equipment room is identical, looks just like this, all operates identical. It's got the home screen, and at the bottom is a scrolling bar where you will select the room that you're in. So you can scroll through, basically outdoor areas, say main pool area. Main pool has the 8 mood media channels. It has a master because you've got the main pool area volume, but there's a separate volume control for the pool bar and the bath. The pool bar and the pool bath zone is combined. So you can have the music playing at the pool a lot louder, but you can separately adjust it for the pool bar and bath. And so you're not blowing away people at the bar. So that's why there's two master volumes above, depending what you select here first. Then you could adjust your volume separately for the pool and the pool bar and bath. Say at the Port of Cashier is kind of similar. The Port of Cashier and Breezeway. The Port of Cashier and Breezeway have speakers mounted in the ceilings. Okay, but we also have a separate system that's mounted out in the entryway, the pull-up area, which is a complete separate system that has two subwoofers and about 9 or 10 satellite speakers. So you can adjust volume in the Port of Cashier. You select your source, then you can go to the Port of Cashier Breezeway Master Gain. You can adjust that, but then out at the entryway, you have a separate master gain. So you can have a separate level there in the pull-up area, which has the extended bass reinforcement versus the Port of Cashier Breezeway, which is just the speakers overhead. Elevator lobby bar, that's the whole area, the barista area. You basically select that, select what you want to play, and you just adjust your level by whatever source that you've selected. Right now, they're all up, and they're all muted, so nothing's playing in that area. So you could walk over into that area, select the mood media, unmute it, then adjust your level, which is comfortable for that area. You've got a restaurant and outdoor dining. The restaurant has your main restaurant. There's an outdoor dining that, which has speakers outside. Then you also have your private dining. So they have their own source, private dining. You select private dining. You got mood media 1 through 8. The private dining has plates in the wall for an aux input. Say someone brings in an iPod or their phone and they want to play music, they could plug that into a plate and they could play, have that play. There's also an air media, which is like the streaming box that we had in the meeting rooms. There's a separate input plate for an air media just in the private dining. You can select the restaurant. The restaurant has all the mood medias. They also have access to the aux input. Say they have a whole big event, including the private dining, and they want to plug an iPod in the private dining jack, you could have that playing throughout the whole restaurant and the outdoor dining. Since you have an outdoor dining area, there's a master gain just for the outdoor dining, so you can adjust that separately from the master gain for the sound within the restaurant. So you got a little more control in these areas that have outdoor speakers. So I've given master gains so that you can have separate volume. So basically, this scrolling wheel starts at the ballroom, which has that same layout that I told you about. All the rooms, room combine, the same faders for background music source and master. There's a pre-function area, which is the whole area all around the ballroom in the hallways, including the bathrooms. So it has its own source selection and volume controls. We went through the spa. The fitness club we didn't go into, but that's a separate room down the hall from the spas, which has another one of those BSS keypads with the four buttons and the knob. There's another one in the fitness club, but it operates identical to the ones in the spa. So using this iPad, which if you want to walk around into different areas and set up music in all the different areas and with the set up the volumes, that's where the iPad really comes in handy. Because there's a lot of areas that do not have a touchscreen. So the only way to control it is through the iPad or the touch panel that's in the rack. But touch panel in the rack, you can't be in the room that you're controlling. You can diagnose some things, but the iPad is where you can walk anywhere and control anything.